Thank you for tuning in to Share a Talk with Evangelist King. Today, we're going to talk about the chastening of the Lord. The word chasten means discipline, correct, and the word correct can be broken down to mean approve or endorse. Deuteronomy chapter 8, verse 5, it reads, "Thou shalt also consider in thine heart that as a man chasteneth his son, so the Lord thy God chasten thee." Now we know, as if you are a parent, especially if you are a loving father and you have a son who you love very much, whenever you see that son going astray, your first reaction is to chase them, which is to discipline them, to correct them. Why? Because you love them. Because that is the way that you are endorsing them and you are approving them as your loving son. Well, just like the father, earthly father, chastens his son, God also chastens his children. He disciplines them. He corrects them for approval and endorsement. So the chastening of the Lord is a good thing, because he only chastens those who he loves. According to Hebrews chapter 12 verse 6, it says, "For whom the Lord loves, he chastens and scourges every son whom he received." So in other words, everyone who God loves, he disciplines them. He corrects them. He approves them. He endorses them. So the chastening of the Lord is not grievous. If we will endure chastening, according to Hebrews 12 verse 7, God deals with us as an earthly father deals with his sons. "For what son is he whom the father chastens not?" So the Lord always chastens his children. Why? Because he cares for us. Proverbs 13 verse 24 read, "He that spares his rod really hates his son." Dear heart, if God himself did not love us, he will not discipline us, which is he will not correct us. He will not approve us or endorse us as his loving son if he did not chase us or correct us. Because again, according to Proverbs 13:24, if he didn't love us, he would not chasing us. Because again, he that beareth his rod really hates his son. Love, who is God himself, love is his attribute. That is who he is. That's the best way to describe him. Refuse to allow us to stay in the same old condition. Why? Because he love us. And he wants us to become like him and to remain like him, because he loves us. And he does it, he shows his love for us through chastening, through discipline, through correction. That is his way in approving or endorsing us as his son. If the Lord right now is not chastening you, correcting you, disciplining you, you are in big trouble. Because the evil one himself does not discipline. Does not discipline. Why? Because he do not love you. He hates you. He's doomed, and his desire is for you also to be doomed. But Jesus Christ, again, refused to leave us in the same condition. Right now, dear heart, You under the sound of my voice. If you happen to be part of any leadership that does not in love and through love by the Holy Spirit dwelling in them, chasing you, which is correct you, discipline you through and by love, you need to run. And what I mean is, and dear heart, this is not done all the time verbally. It's done by one's lifestyle. Because if you are part of any leadership and you know you are struggling and willfully practicing a particular problem, you're dealing with a particular issue in your heart that only you, God, and the devil knows all about. But yet and still, when you're around those who you say are your mentors, and there's no conviction, or there's no discipline of correction coming forth from that mentor spirit by the Holy Spirit to correct you, then that only means that something is wrong. Because when you are truly around a man or a woman of God who are your mentor, and they have been led and guided by the Holy Spirit who dwells in them, and they are submitted to the Holy Spirit leading and guidance, then the Holy Spirit through them is going to refuse to leave you in the same old condition. He knows what you're dealing with. And out of their mouth will come discipline. Will come correction. Why? Because the Father is approving you and endorsing you as his loving son. Every time he disciplines you and corrects you, that's the way the Father is saying to you, I have approved you and I am endorsing you as my son. But again, if that is not happening through that mentor that you are associating with, well then, just like Proverbs 13:24 say, he that spares his rod hateth his son. That is the evil one working on the inside of them, keeping you in your same old ways because he do not care for you. You understand what I'm saying, dear heart? Be careful in who you choose as your mentor. Because remember, the Father, our Heavenly Father, disciplines, correct those, chasing those whom he loved. And by doing so, that is his stamp of approval and endorsement that we are his son. If you are not receiving discipline and correction in your life, through and by the Holy Spirit working through the mentor, and your life is not being touched and changed where men can see the good deeds that you're doing for God and toward God, then you need to disconnect that fellowship, because that is an unhealthy relationship. See, a relationship starts first in the spirit realm. In the natural, we choose as mentors based on what our eyes desires. That means what we desire them to look like. If they look like they're somebody, then we'll say they are somebody. That is not how the Lord rates an individual. He rate an individual from the inside out, not the outside in. So therefore, again, if you under a mentor in the chastening of the Lord by the Holy Spirit through that mentor is not disciplining you, not correcting you, and I'm talking about your way of living, your lifestyle, and your lifestyle is not changing, it appears to others from the outside through deceitfulness that you're okay because the world can only go by sight, but you know in your heart there are issues that you're dealing with. But yet and still, when you're around this mentor, you feel comfortable because that darkness is exposed. So that means that is that person, your mentor, that you have associated yourself with, have not submitted themselves to be led and guided by the Holy Spirit, where the Father, through Jesus Christ, can chasten you, which therefore stamps his approval and endorsement that you are his son. So therefore, you need to disconnect that unhealthy relationship and ask the Father to connect you to the mentor that he have chosen specifically for you. Every mentor that the Holy Spirit has set on this earth, have raised up on this earth to mentor someone, they themselves have submitted their spirit to the leadership and guidance of the Holy Spirit, and they allow the Holy Spirit through them, and they receive themselves the chastening of the Lord, the discipline, the correction of the Lord, the approval and endorsement that they are God's son. So therefore, the Lord through them, who is love, will show forth you love. And when you're around them, they don't have to open their mouth, but their very lifestyle and the love that's in them will radiate through them, and it will discipline you. It will correct you. It will expose the hidden darkness in your life. It will bring it to light, and you will repent, and you will change. You will not be the same. So this is all good because it is the chastening of the Lord. And it's a lifetime process. The chastening of the Lord, which is his stamp of approval and endorsement that we are his sons. And by the way, this includes women as well. But we're talking about the spirit because there's no gender in the spirit. And since the man symbolizes the headship, God always refers to his children as sons, which really he's talking positional, not genderly, but positional when he says son. But the reason he used son is because positionally the man is the head. The husband is the head, and the wife falls under her husband, leadership, through and by Christ Jesus now, because he have chosen Christ to be his headship. So, in the natural, when the Lord says son, he's talking about male and female. So, but in God's eyesight, we are all sons. So again, the Lord said, he chastened, he disciplined, he corrects. That is his stamp of approval and endorsement that we are his son. If we do not experience the discipline and the correctness of the Lord, then that only means we are not his son. That means we are walking in the kingdom of darkness. So, dear heart, despise not the discipline, the correction, which is the chastening of the Lord. Because, again, it is his stamp of approval in his endorsement that you and I, we are his sons. Praise the living God. And again, be careful in whom you choose as your mentor. Because if your life styled, if your heart is not changing towards your loving Father, towards Christ Jesus by the Holy Spirit, then that means that you are not the Son of God. Because there's no discipline. There's no chastening. There's no chastening. And that relationship is unhealthy, and you need to disconnect from it and ask the Lord to lead you to the mentor that he specifically has chosen to mentor you. That way, your walk will add up with your talk. That way, the world can see the light that radiates from within you, shining bright for the world to see. That way, people's lives that you come in contact with every day will change. Because when you open up your mouth, the Father himself, by the Holy Spirit, through Christ Jesus, speaks for. That way, you'll be living in the power and authority of the Holy Spirit. That way, you will present to the Lord fruit that he's pleased of. Praise the living God. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for your discipline, for your correctness. We thank you for your seal of approval, your endorsement, which shows us that truly we are your sons, because you chasten us, you correct us, you discipline us, because it proves to us that you love us and you refuse to allow us to stay the same. Father, thank you for your chastening in Jesus' name. Dear heart, thank you for tuning in again with Share Talk with Evangelist King. And always remember, dear heart, in your getting, be sure you get understanding. Shalom.